You're listening to the Moon Griffon Show podcast on KPEL965.com.
News Talk 96.5 KPEL, Brobridge, Lafayette.
How much is enough? I'm Therese Crowley, Fox News. Israel out with a swift investigation of the IDF drone strike that killed seven aid workers on a food delivery in Gaza. A retired general concluding Israeli troops violated the army rules of engagement and mishandled critical information. But will this be enough to hold off a loss of U.S. support by President Biden after his phone talk with Israel's prime minister, warning the humanitarian situation must improve?
The Israeli military says the colonel who ordered the series of drone strikes that killed the seven World Central Kitchen aid workers in Gaza has been dismissed, along with the major who said that someone in their convoy was armed, which was untrue. Three others have been reprimanded for their roles in the strikes. Israel's investigation into the deaths also faulted officers for not reading messages alerting the troops that cars, not aid trucks, would carry the workers from the warehouse where the aid was handed out, leading to what Israel called a misidentification. World Central Kitchen is demanding an independent commission to investigate the killings, saying the Israeli military can't credibly investigate its own failure. Tanya J. Powers, Fox News.
World Central Kitchen says there need to be systemic changes. Israel has agreed to more aid. President Biden will take an aerial tour of an American disaster, the collapse of the Francis Scott Key Bridge that's crippled the Port of Baltimore.
The president is traveling with Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg to hear directly from federal and state officials about the massive cleanup underway at the Francis Scott Key Bridge and meet with loved ones of the six construction workers killed.
As the president said, within hours of the collapse, this administration will be with the people of Baltimore every step of the way.
White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre says the Small Business Administrator met with small business owners impacted by the closure of the Baltimore port, a major hub for shipping cargo. President Biden has pledged the federal government will cover the cost of rebuilding the bridge.
America is listening to Fox News.
Progressive presents 10 things on a food truck owner's to-do list that are harder than getting a commercial auto insurance quote. Stocking the fridge, prepping the stations, finding employees that get along well, finding employees that actually do their job. Looking at you, Gary. Balancing the books, balancing the flavors, having a fresh menu and fresh produce and fresh meat, but never a fresh mouth. But the easiest thing on a small business owner's to-do list? Seeing if you can save on commercial auto insurance. Get a quote in as little as 6 minutes at progressivecommercial.com. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Coverage subject to policy terms and conditions.
Hey everyone, it's Ted from Consumer Cellular, the guy in the orange sweater, and this is your wake-up call. If you're paying too much for wireless service, you don't have to keep having that nightmare. Consumer Cellular has the same fast, reliable coverage as the leading carriers for up to half the cost. So why keep spending more than you have to? Seriously, wake up and call 1-888-FREEDOM or visit ConsumerCellular.com.
Savings based on cost of Consumer Cellular single line 1, 5, and 10 gig data plans with unlimited talk and text compared to lowest cost single line postpaid unlimited talk, text, and data plans offer.
It's time to win cash. Get your KPEL News app ready because here's your chance to win up to $30,000. Just enter the following code into your KPEL News app where it says win cash and make sure you listen for more codes throughout the day because the more codes you enter, the better your chances. Here is your next code.
Your 9 o'clock cash code is 6-4-4. That is 6-4-4.
My suit can still make an impression.
And my lamp can bring others a bright future.
Because when I donate my stuff to Goodwill, it helps fund job placement and training for people right in my community.
Goodwill. Donate stuff. Create jobs. Find your nearest donation center at goodwill.org. Brought to you by Goodwill and the Ad Council.
Bikers Against Child Abuse empowers children to not feel afraid of the world in which they live. For more information, visit bacaworld.org. Our helpline is 866-885-9474. BACA. Breaking the chains of abuse.
This hour of the Moon Griffon Show is brought to you by 1% Lists Acadiana. Call Shannon LeBlanc today at 337-522-0682. Save on fees, not on service.
The views expressed in the following show are those of the hosts or hosts only. They do not represent News Talk 96.5 KPEL or Town Square Media.
Hello, welcome Moon Griffon Show. Great to have you with us as we rock and roll. It is Friday. For some of you folks looking forward to the weekend, it is approaching pretty quick. Anyway, great to have you back with us. 844-766-6607. It is a Matthew James Tax and Wealth Management Hotline. A lot of stuff to cover today. Blake Miguez is going to join us a little bit. It's a Basin Bridge thing over here on I-10. The good news is there's a bill that's passed the committee to repeal the stupidity of putting cameras on a bridge. Number two, yesterday also got a bill passed. I didn't realize the fine for going fast on that interstate, $700. They more than doubled it. I got a ticket on that bridge one time. Iberville Parish, my hometown. I could have called the sheriff. I knew him, but I didn't. I paid my ticket. It was around $300. Hadn't been caught since. But one of the bills to take that away. And look, we need to do this, folks, because there's a camera company out there, and Blank Page Cortez is tied to a lobbying group. That former Senator Michaud was there. And they represented one of these groups. And I'm waiting to find a contract for these cameras. There's a contract out there. And I think what Miguez and them are trying to do, folks, it's just really simple. Put the speed limit the same for the cars and the trucks and let the parishes, because that thing goes across a couple parishes, let those folks police it. And if you say, well, it's going to cost too much money, then let those folks get the money so they can pay people to police it to slow people down. I mean, this doubling the fines and putting cameras on there, and you're going to get them. Here's what's going to happen. They said if you go 60 miles an hour, it takes 17, 18 minutes. I forget the time. What's going to happen is somebody's going to get on that interstate. They're going to forget about the cameras. They're going to get about halfway across and go, oh, my God, I'm doing 70 miles an hour. I better slow down. I'm going to pull off the side of the road. They're going to pull off the side of the road. I guarantee you, pull off the side of the road. Think I'm outsmarting them. I'll pull off the side of the road and give myself about 5 or 6 minutes and crank back up. So when I cross it, it will show that I made it in the right time. People are going to be looking at it. It's a bad move. But Blank Page and them did this. I'm going to find out, folks, if we don't beat this. But there's good news. A lot of lawmakers don't want this either. They passed it because Blank Page Cortez was a Senate president, and that's his bill. He's the guy that expanded all the gambling, too, but that's his bill. That's his bill because somebody's going to make a lot of money. If it's about safety, don't give a private entity a bunch of money if it's about safety. Because it's not about safety. It's about somebody making a buttload of money. Very simple. This is a good bill. Anyway, Blake's going to come talk about that later during the course program. I got Jacob Isaac. He's at EV deals. But this thing is dying quick, and that's good. Tim Metcalf for joining us as usual. The governor is Governor Lander, big fan of him. Known Jeff for a long time. I'm really, this national anthem thing with the LSU basketball team has really been, this is so blown out of proportion. It's not even funny. And I'm starting to wonder, what is Landry doing now? He's going on Newsmax. He's going on Fox. He's making it kind of a national deal. Is Jeff running for president? Listen, I watch Bobby Jindal. Boy, did I watch Bobby Jindal. Bobby Jindal was running for president as soon as he became governor. I'm not saying Jeff is running for governor, president. That's not what I'm saying. But all this stuff to go on Fox and Newsmax is not doing anything to knock our insurance rates down. Nothing. It's not doing anything to stop the crime. It's not doing anything to promote Louisiana business. It's not doing anything to stop our migration. Fox and Newsmax and all this stuff dealing with the national anthem. Hell, they playing the national anthem at the game. We're already playing the national anthem at the game. And if you want all the teams to be there, Walker, we talked about it. Remember the Pelicans game? What'd you tell me they'd do? They would do what?
Do the national anthem before they get called out.
But everybody's on the court. And the horn goes off.
Yes.
How hard is that? Just move the national anthem to right before the game and the kickoff. Everybody's there. But see, here's the problem. Jeff has sent out a deal to these universities and regions saying, y'all better come up with a policy. Everybody's on the court. Are they going to lose their scholarships? And I tell you what, if I'm – let's just pick a school that nobody hardly knows, Alabama. I got a recruit in the football team. And a recruit don't know a dang thing about that. And somebody got their scholarship taken away from them. You know, how easy is it to recruit against LSU? Hey, man, you know, got kids over there losing scholarships. For what? Now, look, I've been around it enough to know a coach will say anything. Hey, man, they're taking scholarship from kids if they don't do exactly what they tell them to do. All of a, go ask these coaches what's going to happen with some of that. This thing just, it keeps getting bigger on something that's really a nothing burger in a way. Now, somebody's going to say, because I had people, or I had a guy email me, I ain't listening to you no more. You ain't patriotic. I said, good, I got too many listeners. Why don't you just go away. Then he emails me back. He says, sitting around a dinner table, you just lost some more people when I told them about you. I finally told him, I emailed him back and said, look, you're not listening to me anymore. Quit emailing me too. It'd be nice. That's how crazy this has gotten. And I just don't understand the governor's vision for the state because we're running on Fox and Newsmax. Somebody said, and you beating up Jeff Flynn? I'm not. I love Jeff to death. But Jeff cannot be Bobby Jindal. If he's Bobby Jindal, he's going to fail. I want him to concentrate on the state and all the important stuff. Here we are on Newsmax and Fox and things of that nature. And anybody that calls, and I got very few, but I got some mad at me because they think I'm against the national anthem, and that's BS. They ought to play it. They are playing it. I just understand sports. If you hadn't played sports and basketball, football, and things of that nature where you're going to field and warm up, you go into the locker room, and you come back out. I played at a high school that did that. I played in a college. And let me just tell you something. It's exactly what you did. You went in, warmed up, and went back into the dressing room. Okay? Folks, just I love Jeff to death. I think Jeff's the right guy. If Jeff concentrates on Louisiana, not Fox and Newsmax. This has just really gotten to be ridiculous. And so, and look, Jeff makes his calls, does what he want to do. Maybe Jeff's going to make some kind of things going to happen all the way through the country. I just don't care about Jeff having a big name all over the country. I'm wishing Jeff Landry the same thing I wanted for Bobby Jindal. I want Jeff to concentrate on Louisiana and the problems that we need to fix here. That's what I got Jeff. That's why I'm glad Jeff's the governor. I'm not mad at Jeff. Jeff can come over here and talk about it if he wants to, but sending out talking about losing scholarships, I'm going, man, if I'm another school, I'm going out of this state, I'm going, they're going to take away your scholarships. Because they're a young kid. You tell them you're going to take away a scholarship? That's not good. I just don't think that's the message. But I'm not Jeff, but I'm hoping Jeff's going to do something about tort reform. I hope that's important. I hope we're going to do something about insurance rates. That's important. I hope we're going to do something about out-migration, bring the kids back. Let's create the jobs here. And I don't know how this does any of that. But we're on Fox and we're on Newsmax. Somebody told me he was on Newsmax this morning at 9 o'clock. He's on it now, I guess. Now, somebody's going to call you, Moon's blasting you. Sound like I blasted it. Just don't. I remember Bobby Jindal. And Obama did a press a deal, and here comes Bobby Jindal. Timmy Tebow had him looking like he was trying to run for president, and everything he did was on a national scene. I don't care about the national scene right now. I care about Louisiana. We're going to see what people think about the national scene come November. And here's the good news. The national anthem is being played. Move it. Okay, just move it. I just don't understand. You know, we got a session going on right now. What's moving through the Senate? He wants a constitutional convention. I just think you ought to be talking about why. We ought to be talking about why. How are we going to get this job thing turned around? I just think that's what our governor needs to focus on. And I'm not saying he's not. I'm just saying this is kind of drifting off to something else, and it reminds me of Bobby Jindal, who drifted off and he wanted that national stage. Well, what stage do you want, Louisiana or national? I'm not mad at him at all. I'm trying to understand. He may have to do what Edwards did to Senator Hewitt. He may can explain it to me, but he can't understand it for me because I don't understand this. I really don't. I'm kind of sitting here just kind of, wow, why am I talking about this crap for the fifth day in a row? Whose fault is that, folks? Me? Guilty? Totally guilty. Just I know what Jeff wants to do in the state. I've heard the message. I saw what the people and how they responded. I saw how the people responded to Jeff. They put him in there. I saw him respond. Two-thirds Republicans in the House, two-thirds in the Senate. Oh, man, we're looking good. We're now chasing Fox and Newsmax and Breitbart and everybody writing news stories, and the governor's on, and I'm just trying to understand. I know what we can do control, what you can control. And he can't control. He sent out a letter to Regis saying, hey, y'all do something about this. Well, it's an easy fix. Hey, we're going to do the national anthem right before the game. Walker talked about the Pelicans. He's been there. He's seen it every time. You know? And here's the other thing. If Malkin and them were protesting the national anthem, I'd have a different take on this. But that's not what's going on. So anyway, I just wish the governor come back here. Let's get the job done here and quit worrying about Fox and Newsmax on things that I don't know what the angle is on this. But I know this. Governor Landry has a big task of him after 8 years of the worst governor ever. 16 years of the worst two governors. And it put us back 25 years. We got such a big job to do here. That's what I want him to focus on. Just me. If I'm wrong, folks, you're welcome to call 844-766-6607, Matthew James Tax Wealth Management Hotline, or you can email me moon@moongriffon.com. And here's the best news of the day. You ready? We're going to give away Raging Cajun gift pack, seasonings, food stuff. Go check them out. Raging Cajun. All you got to do is email me moon@moongriffon.com. Say you want to win. Leave me an address. We'll pick a winner at the end of the second hour. So let's take a break. 844-766-6607. You're listening to the Moon Griffon Show.
Time, and that means garden time here in Louisiana, and Louisiana owned and operated Stein is where you need to go to get all the great deals on plants and everything else you need for that brand new flower bed you've been wanting to make. Stein has great deals on garden soil, mulch, weed and ant killer, everything you need to lay the groundwork for that brand new flower bed, plus assorted flowers and vegetables in jumbo six packs starting at just $2.79. The weather is perfect, and that means you have the opportunity to start bringing those great blossoms into your yard today. Plus, springtime means outdoor cooking, grills, charcoal and propane burners, all of that you need you can find online at steinhome.com. Louisiana owned and operated, Stein is your place for the gardening and outdoor grilling you need to take advantage of this spring. Check out everything they have to offer online at steinhome.com. That's steinhome.com. Check them out today.
When you think about how you'll spend your money in retirement, what comes to mind? Probably travel, sunny beaches, and spoiling your grandchildren. But a recent survey found that over 30% of every dollar a retiree spends goes to taxes. Baby boomers were told for years to save money in their IRAs and 401ks and pay taxes later. Well, now that day has arrived, and boomers are shocked to see a third of their money going back to Uncle Sam. John Blanchard and the Matthew James Financial Group can help. What if you could protect all or most of your retirement wealth from future tax rate increases? Achieve a zero or near zero effective tax rate for most of your retirement years. Find out more. 337-366-8366. Isn't it time you got a second opinion on your wealth and retirement outlook? Learn how you could potentially kick the IRS out of your IRA. 337-366-8366 and online at MatthewJames.com. This is Moon Griffon. Hi, y'all. Welcome back. Moon Griffon Show. What a great day. It is Friday. Beautiful day. Beautiful, beautiful day. I got to where I like Fridays a little bit more than I used to. Somebody said, everybody loves Friday. I know. I always thought Monday was the best day of the work week. Had a whole week to get it right, baby. All right, 844-766-6607, Matthew James, Tax and Wealth Management Hotline. Go to phone lines. We'll go to Shreveport. We'll go to Allison. Allison, how you doing?
Hey, Moon. How are you?
Doing great, Shaq. Good to hear from you.
Hey, I agree with you about Governor Landry. I love him, but this isn't the fight I need him to fight.
Well, everybody's for the national anthem being played. My God, this is not what we're talking about. And, you know, Iowa standing out there was impressive. I'm not arguing with that. But just don't understand, man, we got so many things to change in Louisiana. I just don't want him getting off track of what he's really trying to accomplish. And that's my only reason for coming back on here again today was, Governor, to stay on track with this state.
Well, I struggle with someone making me. I'm all for standing. I love America. I love the national anthem. I love Kim Mulkey. I love the LSU Tigers. However, I don't want to ever be forced to do something. I don't want our country to be, we're so patriotic because we always stand for the national anthem, but then we're going to be punished if we don't. And I just feel like it took a wrong turn somewhere.
Well, my big thing is this. If Kim Mulkey and the team was protesting, that's a whole different issue. I've played athletics enough to know, okay, that and this is how I started on Monday, Allison. We used to go in college as well. I only played a couple of years, had a bummed up knee, but whatever. We used to go into the locker room in high school and college. After about halfway to warm up, the coaches would go back over everything. You'd go back out, finish warming up, and play ball. I didn't know if they prayed, did the national anthem, nothing for many, many years because I was never on the court at a certain time. That's all I'm saying. If they're protesting, I think that's bad. I just want the governor to stay on track with the message that he got and elected officials that they have doing something about this state. And I just think that's where we are. Now, don't get so drifted over here when this is really what you are elected to do. And I don't see it. I don't see the issue here. I may miss the boat on this one, but I don't see the issue here.
Well, and in sports, we couldn't talk to parents. We couldn't talk to people in the crowds. We went in, we got focused on the game, and when we came out, we were playing the ball game. We weren't thinking about other stuff, and I don't think that it was a protest at all. I struggle because the media is pushing that, but they're not looking at the fact that UConn played a game right after LSU played Iowa, and neither one of them was out on the court.
Because this has been the norm forever. I still get a lot of people with LSU football, and there's nothing bigger in sports than LSU sports in general, but in football, there's nothing bigger than football. And they haven't done it in a long time. This is my big thing, Allison. You could say I'm sending a message to Jeff. Jeff knows he's welcome to come on. He'll be back. We'll probably talk about it. But I don't want him to miss what we got over here with Louisiana and focus on so many things we got to fix. That's it. I just don't want to get off on this. I want to get off. I want to do what we have to do in the state of Louisiana. And if I'm wrong, I'll be the first one to apologize.
You're not wrong. Wait, I'm a constituent. I was so excited about Jeff Landry running. I'm still going to vote for him. I just don't want him tackling this when there's so much going on. And when we have the House and the Senate and the governor, let's get some things done.
Yeah, that's where I like to focus. And when you start seeing the Fox and the Newsmax and all that stuff, that's when I start worrying about the focus. Focus needs to be right here. Let him. Hey, Jeff's welcome to come on.
Listening.
Jeff can come on the program next week. I'll put him on in a second. We sit down and talk about this. I have no problem with it.
I'm not listening to you.
Well, see, Allison, I'm not hiding anything. I'm not going behind the back of anybody. I'm just saying I don't want to lose focus on what we got ahead of us. And this is becoming like, I mean, I'm talking about something I don't want to talk about, Allison. How about that? That's stupid on my part. I'm telling you it's stupid on my part. But on the flip side, I just don't understand it. I'm trying to understand it.
We're all talking about it. But I hope you have a great weekend.
All right. You too, Allison. God bless. Appreciate it. Somebody said the fact that Iowa was present, not LSU, made it much worse. I think the audience may want to address the fact that even though it was not intentional, it's time for change and maybe to the point as our governor is trying to make. Okay, Marie writes me. You keep telling us you're missing the point. Remember when the NFL? Yeah, I remember all that. What's the difference? It's a big difference, gigantic difference. So, if they were, and by the way, I agree with you, Marie. I just told you how to fix it. It's all of them just move it up right before the game. Fixed. And you can see if somebody wants to protest and all that stuff. But this has just been something going on. If you want to change it, Marie, let me ask you, can Jeff change the policy in Louisiana? Yes. Does he have to go on Fox and Newsmax to do it? No. We'll be right back. Hey, folks, this is Moon Griffon. I built my dream home. Start imagining your dream home. And when you do, make sure you call my friends and get in touch with my friends at Schumacher Homes. SchumacherHomes.com, SchumacherHomes.com. When you tour a Schumacher model home, you're in control. Stop by doing operating hours and tour at your own pace. There's a reason my friends at Schumacher have been building homes for over 30 years. They're committed to making the home building process as enjoyable, simple, and hassle-free as possible. Call them or visit them, SchumacherHomes.com. SchumacherHomes.com to schedule your free, no obligation design and pricing meeting. Hey, it's an hour or two of your time working on your dream home. And my friends over at Schumacher Homes just announced some exciting news. You can get a mortgage rate as low as 2.875% when you finance with Schumacher Homes. That is 2.875% when you finance with Schumacher Mortgage. Hey, the whole Schumacher team is dedicated to making sure your dream home becomes a reality. SchumacherHomes.com, SchumacherHomes.com. Folks, remember the name, All Field Equipment, AllFieldEquipment.com. When I say All Field, that's allfield.com. All Field Equipment founded in 2016 by my good friend, Mr. Bill Allen, with over 50 years experience in the oil and gas industry. Hey, this is a great company to do business with. Whether it's production equipment, control valves, controller, glyco pumps, chemical pumps, chokes, Wilden pumps, Barton recorders, All Field has new rebuilt and parts. All Field handles some of the industry's top brands such as Norseal, Fisher, and Kimray. On the supply side, All Field has anything from Q-tips to appliances to general All Field supplies. All Field is one of the largest suppliers of bottled water in the Gulf. And remember, All Field never changes transportation. Like the name says, All Field has it all, covering the Architects area and the Gulf of Mexico. All Field Equipment, 337-837-1003, 337-837-1003.
Everywhere you turn.
This hour of the Moon Griffon Show is brought to you by 1% List Acadiana. Call Shannon LeBlanc today at 337-522-0682. Save on fees, not on service.
Hi, hello. Welcome back. Moon Griffon Show, open forum Friday. You can talk about anything you want to talk about, 844-766-6607. It's the number if you want to be part of it. It's opportunity. It's a Matthew James Tax Wealth Management hotline. Couple of items in this segment. 2024 hurricane season forecast includes the highest number of hurricanes ever predicted. The highest number ever predicted. Now, so I, doing what I normally do, I start asking myself questions. I go, self, then I go find somebody that really knows what's going on. So did a little research, talked to the climate czar too. Stephen Parr, did some research on my own. Let me tell y'all what's going on. I just want you to notice, because this is what every news outlet had. So they're naming record number of hurricanes ever. Let me tell you what, years ago, not many years ago, you know, when you're watching the news and they're showing you a little storm coming off the Africa coast and it disintegrates or it goes up, it goes north and then back to northeast, and you never hear about it, never hits anything. They used to never count those storms. You know that? You know, they get the number, okay, and they base it off some stuff. And I got some new numbers going to come in from Stephen Parr and somebody else dealing with hurricanes. And so they said 23 storms, 11 hurricanes. They used to never count all that stuff. That's why they can say, you see, we got more than ever. Well, if you change the criteria of the way you count hurricanes and storms, you're going to come up with a bigger number. There's your little storms would pop out there and then it would disintegrate. They would pop out and they would get strong and then they would disintegrate. They would pop up, not even get close to the United States or Mexico or anywhere else, and they would go up and nobody would ever hear about them because they never affected anything. So this is all in this climate green craziness to tell you. So the 23 named storms, so what if none of them hit us? 11 named hurricanes, 5 major hurricanes. You know, they count a major hurricane that gets up to a Cat 3, 4, 5. that never touches one inch of land anywhere. So it's all manipulated to believe, well, it's worse than it used to be. Highest number of hurricanes ever predicted. What does that mean? The only hurricanes I care about are storms that we care about, folks. It's really simple. It's the ones that hit either the United States or even other countries. There's no more hurricanes than they've ever been. There's no more hurricanes hitting than they've ever been. You know, Lake Charles, well, we never got hit two in a row, but one time. That might be true. It's always the first time for everything. Louisiana, where we had four or five in a couple of years, by the grace of God, we've had none the last 2 years. They told us there will be worse, intensify more, we're going to get more of them, but that's not true. So I just looked at it and I thought, just for information's sake, are we let me ask you a question. So let's say Major League Baseball used to play on 300-foot fences, and now they play on 400-foot fences. And you looked at how many home runs were hit then and how many home runs are hit now. You said, well, there ain't as many home runs hit now. No, because the fences were closer. The stats have to change with it. You know? Caitlin Clark set the NCAA scoring record in 4 years. Pete Maravich did what he did in three. Really not comparable. What Caitlin Clark's doing is phenomenal. It's up there with Pete. It's awesome. But it's not comparable. So I'm just, it's amazing. It's amazing. So anyway, the hurricane season, you can't buy into what they're telling you. I only worry about hurricanes that hit the United States and Louisiana. The rest of them, I don't care about. You shouldn't either. Not what the media does. Record number of hurricanes ever predicted. Record number. Record number. All right, Robert Allen. Senator Allen, how you doing, man? How you been?
I'm doing good. How are you?
I'm doing superb. Okay, what did I say wrong?
Nothing. I just want to defend Governor Landry. I just want to say this.
All right.
Governor Landry has assembled a great team of smart people, and we're moving at the fastest pace that state governments ever move. So I just want to be clear that nothing's slipping through the cracks. He's on top of things. His team is on top of things. We are moving policy through the system. So I really don't. It's not an issue I would have picked, the issue you're talking about. I'm not talking about if he should have talked about that issue, but I personally don't have any problem with him getting on Newsmax, getting on Fox. He's on top of things. We're getting complaints that government's moving too fast. You're not going to please everybody, but it's refreshing to me that the clip at which we're moving.
Yeah, I just don't want to drift, and I don't think this is worth drifting on, this particular issue. I saw Bobby Jindal drift and he stayed drifted. And I don't want Jeff to do that. That's all. It's not if you listen to me, I'm not cutting Jeff. I'm saying we need to make sure we don't lose sight of what we have happening in Baton Rouge. I don't want to lose sight of that.
And I'm with you. I understand your point. I just see it a little bit different. I think he's taking care of his business. And was asked to do these interviews. I understand you, and I agree with you. Nobody wants another governor that's drifting or looking at another job. My personal opinion is that things are taken care of, and he has time to do these interviews.
Well, it's like I tell you, I love, you ever heard of preemptive stuff? Well, don't drift that way. Yep. So that, Robert, Senator Allen, that's what I'm doing. I'm preempting. I don't want to drift. I don't want to drift from the goal, because we need the governor, and I know he's got a great staff. Like I said, this is not a cut. This is just challenging. Hey, man, let's not. I just watched Jindal do that. Him and Timmy Teeple wanted to be president before he became governor, and I want Jeff to stay on all the issues that we voted for him. And, hey, look, I'm not arguing with you. I hear the same thing. You're down there. You know more than I do. But I just want to make sure we don't do it, and that's the reason for bringing this up.
I agree with you, Moon, and I do appreciate you staying on top of everybody. You're fair, and you know, you're doing your job too, so I appreciate that.
Yeah, all right. No, Seth Island. Thank you, man. Anytime, you're always welcome.
Thank you. Have a good one, man.
I appreciate it. Hey, good. Look, I'm glad to hear that, and I've heard other people say that. But he actually had the guts to call and say it, but I just don't want to drift from it, and I'm not going to drift from it me personally because I'm watching from the best way I can. And I know Jeff's the man for the job, and we want him to continue to be that man for the job because we sent a lot of people to do the work. All right, let's go Frank in Monroe. Frank, how you doing?
Hey, doing great. Like to talk about climate change. What's the one thing they never say on any of the stories about weather? How old the Earth is?
Oh, yeah.
It's 4.6 billion years old. Our records go back to 1882. So we're taking 141 years out of 4.6 billion and saying if we don't change everything, the Earth will be gone in 10 years. They've been saying that for 100 years. And do you know what an atmospheric river is? It's a thunderstorm, but it's a lot scarier when you say that.
Yeah, I mean, know when you start talking about wrecking hurricanes and the weathers. Well, if 20 years ago and 10 years ago, they didn't count all them storms that don't mean anything, okay, and now you're counting them, it's going to look worse. That's all. And that's what the media, what the meteorologists do. It's what the Green New Agenda is all about. Yeah. And that's it. It's just silly for me to start predicting. It don't matter what's predicted. What matters is what happened. But let me ask you a question. Frank, do you get nervous about a storm? I don't care if it's a hurricane, a Cat 5, if it gets out in the ocean and it starts north and northeast and goes away and you never hear about it, never hits anybody. You get nervous about those storms? I don't. I don't even care about them.
Yeah. And why do they say the worst on record? Why don't they say the worst in the last 142 years?
Well, they're not.
I grew up Blackman's Parish, and I can remember we had a house right against the Mississippi River. I can remember it shaking hurricanes. But we could spend $999 trillion and wouldn't change the temperature 1 degree.
No. And by the way, the change in this makes it. Go ahead.
How do you evacuate New Orleans if everybody was driving electric cars? A lot of them would drown in their car.
I tell you what. Have you ever noticed that water and electricity, that don't mix real well, does it?
Well, but it takes fossil fuel to run the generators, to run the charger. The whole thing is, and I can't believe people fall for it.
Well, you got
retired 11 years ago. I said, you know what? In 4 or 5 years, gas is going to be a fire. So I bought me a Prius. I have a 20 Prius. I got 80,000 miles, and I average 54 miles a gallon. A 12-gallon tank. I can drive 640 miles, stop for 5 minutes, and go another 640.
Absolutely.
Why would I want to spend $50,000 for an electric car to drive 230 miles and then have to stop for a couple hours to charge it?
Yep, you got it. Brother, listen, the whole thing is idiotic, but this hurricanes and tropical storm predictions are just as bad. And meteorologists don't tell you that. Anyway, I got to run. Thanks for the call. I just see these storms. I'm going, wow, boy, that's a lot. Big prediction. Yeah. Based on what? Anyway, we'll take a break. 844-766-6607. Got an open line for you on Open Forum Friday. You're listening to the Moon Griffon Show. From the humbling beginning, Dino Hardwoods is striving to provide superior service and quality products for their customers. Hey, I know Charles Altman. He does a great job. If you're looking for lumber, Dino Hardwood stocks a large selection of domestic and import hardwood lumber in Cypress. You ought to see their stuff. Exotic lumber, they got that as well. Trust in Dino Hardwood when it comes to your exotic lumber needs right now. Molding, plywood, paint, and L products, they are ready for you. They got 3 great locations. Their corporate office is right here in Broussard, Louisiana. There's an office in Shreveport on 2801 Valley View Drive and one in Tyler, Texas, 12492 Highway 155 North. Hey, if you're looking for something different and something new and somebody who will service you, it's Dino Hardwoods. I'm telling you, don't forget Dino Hardwoods. DinoHardwoods.com, DinoHardwoods.com. Great locations. They can service you. They can deliver. DinoHardwoods.com. Check out this great Louisiana company. Folks, you hear me brag about an advertisement. South Star Urgent Care is the name you need to know. Listen, you look up in the middle of the night, you're looking, God, where do we go? South Star Urgent Care. They open on weekends. They open at night. They can get you taken care of. If you're sick, if you're feeling bad, maybe you coughing, dehydrated, fever, flu, fractures, South Star Urgent Care wants to service you, and they're going to treat you like you want to be treated. They're going to get you in, get you out. You're not going to sit in a dark waiting room for a bunch of times. South Star Urgent Care. Go to southstarmoon.com, southstarmoon.com. You know you can register before you go and set your appointment. Hey, it's really cool. These folks at South Star greet you with a genuine smile and make you feel very comfortable. Folks, you're looking for the perfect urgent care? It's South Star Urgent Care. Go to southstarmoon.com, southstarmoon.com. South Star Urgent Care. It's the urgent care you need. Go to southstarmoon.com, southstarmoon.com. Anyway, folks, this move. Thank you. Hi, hello. Welcome back. Moon Griffon Show. Great to have you with us. 844-766-6607 is the number if you'd like to be part of the program. Matthew James Tax Wealth Management Hotline. All righty. Boy, it must be legislative day on this program. We go to Representative Dixon McMakin, my special. He joins me. Dixon, how you doing?
Hey, great, Moon. Great to talk to you.
Yeah, man, it's always a pleasure. So you heard from the Senate side. Now it's time to hear from the House side, I guess, huh?
Yeah, I didn't want to let Robert Alon get all the credit today, you know, a freshman senator over there. So I figured I'd call in and tell you the House is working just as hard or harder than the Senate, depending on who you talk to.
Well, Senate takes more time off. But I'm going to leave it at that. Senate takes more time off.
Yeah, they're the upper chamber for a reason. But, you know, Moon, I did want to point out something I think that the House is doing this year so well is in committees, we're really committed to vetting the bills in committee and trying to make sure that we don't have bad bills make it to the floor. And that's where it should start. And I think you've seen that with our group so far this year.
No, listen. I'm not, and of course he called in about Jeff and he didn't care if he get on the thing, but I don't want the governor to lose sight of everything y'all trying to do because there's so many issues now. I know y'all just getting the process on the way, but, and I know he's got a good, I know all of his staff, I know a lot of them, but I don't want to drift too much over here when I know one thing, you went in and so did Brett Island, I mean, Robert, they all went in with Jeff, we're going to change the state. And I don't want that. I saw, and you may not remember it, Dixon. Maybe you do. I know you're a lot younger than me, but and you probably do remember. Bobby Jindal got drifted over there to be on national TV and national TV. And I when I looked up and saw that, I just said, "Come on, man, let's not lose sight over here of what we got to fix." So, it's kind of a preemptive strike in a way, saying, "Hey, man, don't forget this is what we got elected for."
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Moon, a lot of people have said I'm younger than you and better looking than you.
that ain't saying much at all, brother, but go ahead.
but you know, we remember the Bobby Jindal days here in Baton Rouge very well. You know, everybody supported him. We were so excited for that bold, positive change mentality. Then the only thing it seemed he wanted to change was his address of where he lived. And I took Jeff having the opportunity, excuse me, Governor Landry, having the opportunity to be on those news channels every time he does that. It brings attention to Louisiana, and I like that. I like when people look at Louisiana and are tuning into us. And I'll say this, pillars I believe in, efficiency and effectiveness. The governor has been very efficient, very effective of how well we are moving right now. So I took it almost as a compliment that he did have a little time to be able to do that. I think Senator Alon kind of expressed that same view as well, that we are moving so well right now that it was an opportunity, but it's good for you to, you know, call people out on that and make sure that we keep our eyes on the prize.
That's the only reason, Dixon, Representative McMakin, that I brought it out. I've been doing this now for, I'm in my 31st year, and I don't say that boastfully. I've been fortunate to hang around 2 years. But I've seen some things drift before, and I'm just making sure, going, okay, hold up just a sec, because I've been saying since Monday I need to move on. I ain't moved on yet. So that I'm bothering myself now, I guess.
Hey,
hey, I'm going to start. You know what I'm going to start doing?
Let God.
I'm going to start talking about me, and not in a nice way.
ain't hard to do that.
No, either, no, that'd be the easiest thing I'd do. Put up a mirror and get to going at myself. But hey, but let me ask you a quick question, though. I got a quick question.
Coming up.
How are we doing? There's a really some important stuff in this session. How are we doing with tort reform or insurance reform or stuff that will really make a difference in people's lives? Tax reform, is that something we're going to do next year? Just overall, some of those big issues that people have to fill it in their pocketbook, Representative McMakin. Can you tell me some stuff like that that you feel really good right up the road that we're going to be able to get done?
Yeah, absolutely. I would say, you know, last week, I believe it was Wednesday night, we were actually on the House chamber floor till past 8 o'clock going through a lot of Commissioner Temple's insurance package bills. And so we got, I believe, all of his package bills off the House floor. And as you know, now they head over to the Senate. They got to go through Senate committee and Senate chamber as well. And we think those are going to get moved and hopefully even get to the governor's desk here early, not wait till August, because the insurance community, they're watching. They want to see what we're doing, and they're watching that. And Secretary of State Nancy Landry, her package is moving along as well. I think all of her package bills have come through as well. And then what I was going to mention, Moon, Monday, Representative Julie Emerson's ESA bill, the Gator bill, is going to be on the House floor, I believe, Monday, which will be a great debate. And something a lot of us ran on and campaigned on very hard is letting the money follow the child. And Monday, I believe that bill is going to get off the House floor. And I'm really excited for that to move over to the Senate side as well.
Yeah, it's a shame, and I say this, but it's a shame you didn't have 1 year with the other leadership to see the difference now, because I'm getting that from people I know in the House and Senate, how things are moving. They're moving well. They're moving fast. And they're telling me we're heading in the right direction, but it's night and day from what they fought the last 4 years to now, what y'all doing. And by the way, y'all got, what, 28, 29 new freshman Republicans. You guys want to see things in a positive way. And a lot of the freshman Republicans are younger people like yourself. You plan on being around a while, so you want to be able to tell people, look at the improvement we made.
28 freshman Republican on the House side. I believe, you know, I'm 37 and a half. I believe I'm the fifth or sixth youngest, you know, so there's five, six other people younger than me. We plan on being around a long time. And like you said, Moon, I was around a lot. I watched a lot. But the collective leadership group I think we have right now, not just the Speaker, Philip DeVilliers, and Cameron Henry, the President of the Senate, but Mark Wright and Jeremy Stein as well, who are the party chairman on each side. It's been wonderful. Their leadership has been great. You know, it's like, tell my dad all the time, it's like being a freshman football player all over again. You got to learn the players, learn who they are. But if you have a great quarterback and running back and offensive coordinator and coach, you can get some things done. I think we're going to bring home some championships to Louisiana.
I hope so. I will say this publicly. Philip DeVilliers has been a pleasant surprise. I knew Philip. I knew Philip was a good guy. I was worried if he was going to be tough enough. But right now, Philip has proven to be a really good leader at the speaker side right now. So I'm glad about that, because I know the Senate. I know Cameron. Cameron can be tough. He might have to beat on him a little bit. But I'm really glad for Philip, because I think Philip DeVilliers has done a good job for what I've seen. And anyway, look, I got to run. Anything you want to add real quick?
Hey, have a great weekend, Moon, and looking forward to getting ESA off the floor on Monday.
Yeah, I hear you. All right, brother. Appreciate it.
Thanks, guys.
Right. Dixon McMakin, Representative Dixon McMakin. Somebody writes, moving in a direction, in the right direction, is not a good word. No, it ain't. That's the ones that worry me. All right, we got to take a break. We'll be back. More of the Moon Griffon Show. Hear from another rep, Representative Blake Miguez. After that, we're going to eat, and we'll continue to move right along. You're listening to the Moon Griffon Show. Line One is a business telecom provider. Line One specializes in cloud-based communication with superior customer service. If you're frustrated with phone bills you can't understand, endless hold time to customer support, and phone system that is not meeting your needs, then you need to go to Line.One and schedule a free consultation to advance your business phone system. Line One, technology with a human touch. Go to Line.One and tell them Moon sent you. Again, that is Line.One. News Talk, 96.5, KPEL, Brobridge, Lafayette, a Town Square Media station, broadcasting from the Matthew James Financial Studio.
From the White House, Gianna Gelosi, Fox News. Israel has agreed to send more aid deliveries into Gaza hours after President Biden warned Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu to change his humanitarian policies or the U.S. can end its support.
The Biden administration says it welcomes new steps and commitments from Israel to open new routes to reach Gaza, including a port and increased aid deliveries from Jordan directly into Gaza. Those announcements from Israel followed a phone call between President Biden and Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu in a warning from the president that future U.S. support will be determined by steps to protect civilians and aid workers. The Israeli Defense Force has also fired two commanders who oversaw and approved the airstrike this week that killed seven aid workers in Gaza. At the White House, Jared Halpern, Fox News.
The U.S. Treasury Secretary calling for a level economic playing field.
During her five-day visit to China, which includes meetings with top Beijing financial leaders, Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen making it clear the Biden administration is asking for change, but wants a relationship that benefits both countries.
Countries around the world watch both of our economies, but also our interactions, as they're crucial to global growth.
Yellen has raised what the administration considers unfair trade practices and has accused Beijing of overstimulating markets with heavily subsidized green energy products, which is making it harder for the U.S. and other countries to make products themselves. That includes solar panels and electric vehicles. In Washington, Ryan Schmelz, Fox News.
And there were 303,000 new jobs created last month. Economists predicted job growth of only 200,000. President Biden released a statement saying today's report marks a milestone with 15 million jobs being created since he took office. America's listening to Fox News.
Don't let everyday aches and pains keep you from living your best life.
I don't think I really understood what people meant when they talked about pain until I started feeling it myself.
Start feeling better every day with Relief Factor, a daily supplement designed to support your body's fight against aches and pains.
Not only do I move better without pain, I just feel better.
Created by doctors, Relief Factor uses a unique formula of natural ingredients that target four metabolic pathways to address pain. Relief Factor doesn't just mask aches and pains, it helps reduce or even eliminate them.
Today, I do the things I love, and it doesn't occur to me to think about pain.
You can feel the difference all day, every day.
Join the over 1 million people who have tried Relief Factor's 3-week quick start kit. It's only $19.95. Visit relieffactor.com or call 1-800-4-RELIEF. That's 1-800-4-RELIEF. And feel the difference of relief.
Court-appointed special advocates, or CASA, are specially trained volunteers that help secure safe homes for abused and neglected children. Don't let these innocent victims slip through the cracks of our complicated legal system. Get involved today. Call CASA at 268-5111. This nonprofit organization moment brought to you by News Talk 96.5 KPEL.
I had an important job. And it wasn't just a job, it was keeping my brothers and sisters safe. And coming back, it felt like kind of thrown away. It's like you're useless. You know, we don't really have a need for you now because you can't really do anything for us. That's the way I felt. If it hadn't have been for Wounded Warrior Project, I honestly don't know if I would be here. It was the camaraderie that I saw and had. It was like, I got my family back again. We all felt the connection, you know, like that brother and sisterhood.
See how Wounded Warrior Project empowers women veterans like Donna
by visiting woundedwarriorproject.org/empowerwomenvets.
It's time to win cash. Get your KPL News app ready because here's your chance to win up to $30,000. Just enter the following code into your KPL News app where it says win cash and make sure you listen for more codes throughout the day because the more codes you enter, the better your chances. Here is your next code.
Your 10 o'clock cash code is 244. That's right, 244.
The views expressed in the following show are those of the hosts or hosts only. They do not represent News Talk 96.5 KPL or Town Square Media.
Hey, y'all. Welcome to Moon Griffon Show. Great to have you back with us. Open forum for Friday, folks. If you'd like to be part of the program, 844-766-6607. Matthew James, Tax Wealth Management Hotline. By the way, we're giving away some, almost put the wrong thing on there. Raging Cajun. Ah, you've heard them on my program many a times. Raging Cajun season. These people are really good. They're doing a heck of a job. Their brand's growing. And they want to be nice to you and thank you. So they're going to give you an opportunity to win some Raging Cajun products, and you're going to like them. I use them. I use them all the time now. I looked up in the pantry. I got more stuff I bought and stuff that they gave me. The IRS ain't listening. Anyway, email me, moon@moongriffon.com, moon@moongriffon.com. And say you want to win, leave an address. I got a lot of people want to win from Baton Rouge and Shreveport to Monroe, Lafayette, Houma, North Carolina, so. All right, let's jump gears. Senator Blake Miguez. I like saying that, Blake, because I know how hard you work to get to be senator and how much crap you had to go through. Senator Blake Miguez, how you doing, man?
Good morning, Moon. How you doing?
Man, I'm doing great because you're working on bills I want to see go away. And one of the big ones that you're making progress, and I'm tickled to death, and I hope it continues because I know there are people lobbying against this, with the stupidity of putting these cameras on the Basin Bridge down on I-10 through the Henderson area. So talk about the bills that passing and moving and what kind of progress we're making on getting rid of that craziness.
Well, thank you, Moon. I appreciate you having me on the show. You bring up a good point. I-10, the Basin Bridge, based on legislation that was passed last year, pushed really hard by the Senate president at the time, would put speed revenue-generating cameras on the I-10 bridge, which goes through my Senate district as well as Senator Caleb Kleinpeter's district. And that is not located in any other part of the state. Currently, it was done in a three-phase process. Phase one and two are complete, which makes sense. That's the safety mechanisms like additional speed signage, indicators of your speed, policies about the flow of traffic. And I'm okay with all that stuff because, you know, safety is our priority, but I can tell you we're not going to prioritize revenue of special interest over safety. So what my bill does is it repeals the act, which basically effectively gets rid of the double speed fines, as well as not executing the contract with a private entity to monitor speed. And basically, in layman's terms, a working man in my district and our people in, you know, St. Martin, Lafayette, St. Landry, Iberia, Vermilion, Acadia, that are driving down, headed to Baton Rouge, are going to get a speeding ticket in the mail weeks later for $700. It makes no sense to me. It doesn't serve a public service to safety. I prefer to have a law enforcement officer out there. I prefer my constituents to be able to face their accusers, and a law enforcement officer who has discretion to know if the speeding ticket is appropriate for the circumstances, as well as fighting sex and drug trafficking that's going across our interstate system every day, and having police present to deter crime. And where do the funds go, Moon? I mean, we're not encouraging speeding by any means, but if someone gets cited and they're written a ticket, wouldn't that person want those funds going to their local criminal justice system and not
would.
The pockets of some private company?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I would. And I think, man, $700 is steep for the average guy, but the bottom line is, and I've been saying this as well, okay, let's do some of the local people. Let the money go back to the local. Don't make it a speed trap. But if they put their presence out there and people are getting tickets, they're going to slow down and let the revenue go to the law enforcement. And I think it's Iberville Parish and St. Martin Parish. Am I correct?
That's right. The way the current legislation was written that we're repealing, or we're attempting to repeal, it basically says that the private entity and the maintenance of the whole speed generating camera, revenue generating cameras, get the first dibs. And then the scraps go to Iberville and St. Martin Parish. Well, why should we put our locals that low a priority? What about putting a law enforcement officer like a sheriff's deputy or a trooper out there, let him write the ticket, and instead of the working man paying $700 for the ticket, that $350 ticket, all of his funds will go to the local level, and he'll learn his lesson because he'll face the accuser. And look, if you've ever been pulled over for speeding, the police officer tells you how dangerous it is to speed. And it's a wake up call, and you're able to understand that you did something, you broke the law, and that no one's happy when they get a speeding ticket, but they learn from that experience, and it deters them from doing it in the future. It doesn't deter anybody when they open their mail 2 weeks later and they get this huge violation. They just get upset and mad, and I don't blame them for being so upset because hell, they might not have been driving their vehicle. It could have been their friend driving their vehicle.
Now, I read a couple of things. Senator Blake Miguez, my special guest, we're talking about these cameras that Senate President pushed, and I'm worried about money going to private sector. I'm still interested in who's got the contract. I don't know if you know that yet. But what about the law enforcement in Iberville Parish and St. Martin Parish? Have you had a chance to talk to those groups and decide what they would like to do in something like this, what they think is best?
Well, yes, we got an opportunity to visit with not only the local sheriffs, but also the district attorneys to get their input. And they showed up in committee, both Sheriff Bro and Sheriff Stasi, who represent St. Martin and Iberville Parish, showed up and they support.
By the way, I'm glad you didn't talk to Stasi about me because me and Brett went to school together for a long time. I know him. I know him well. I hadn't seen him in a while, but I know him really well. From the earth. Just don't ask him no questions.
He showed up and he supported the legislation as well as the two district attorneys, Clayton and Dewey, and they made their case. And also the Sheriff's Association showed up and said, look, our sheriffs invested extra resources in the personnel and the equipment to basically enforce the speed limits on Interstate 10. And now you're going to give that revenue and that ability to a private company, which doesn't provide those extra services like which help public safety, like deterring sex and drug trafficking, as well as when a police officer pulls you over, if you have an unsafe condition on your vehicle or you're driving without insurance, they can identify that immediately through probable cause in their stop. We get so many added benefits from having sheriff's deputies and troopers on the road deterring crime. So it's safe to say that our locals were on lockstep with us in support of repealing this. The two senators, myself and Senator Klein, Peter, support repealing this. This bill has a local impact, and I'm happy that the Transportation Committee in the Senate let this bill out and approved it unanimously, and now it goes to the floor for a vote, and I hope to get this on Governor Landry's desk and get it signed into law. I can tell you the people of my district, Iberia, St. Martin, and Lafayette Parish, we just want to be treated equally with the rest of the state. Yep. A lot of the committee members have extended bridges in similar circumstances in their districts, like the Causeway, or the Twin Span, or I-55, or Lake Charles 210. And we told a story. How would you like it if this was in your district? And if this is a good idea, then it should be a good idea for the entire state. And we can debate that philosophically, these cameras. But don't just put them in my district over some type of special interest, backdoor handshake deal to issue some private contract or somebody to get wealthy off of the people that live in my district. Moon, I told you when I was running as a representative on the campaign trail, I was going to stand up against the political establishment. I was going to be a voice of the people. And if the people entrusted me and sent me to Baton Rouge, I was going to work overtime to make sure that we make our state a better place. They elected myself in the first round, as well as Governor Jeff Landry. We have a mandate. We have to work twice as hard to fix this state, because after the last 8 years on the Governor Edwards, we've been falling behind. And that's what you do when you're falling behind. You work twice as hard. So I'm going to put my heart and soul in the Baton Rouge. I got a package of 20 great conservative bills. Other members are working very hard. We have a Republican supermajority in the legislature, a new Republican governor, and we intend to fix Louisiana and get us off of all those lists those bad lists that were ranked at the bottom of all the good lists. We want to move up. We want to
let me ask you a question. Let me ask you something, Senator Miguez. I'm really curious. How come we don't know? This has been over 2 years since this bill passed. How come we don't know who got the contract? How come we don't know who got the contract for this? What company got the contract? Well, what agency? What lobbyist? How come we don't know that already? I'm just kind of curious.
My understanding, the contract hasn't been issued yet. That's the next step in phase three, and that's what my bill plans to repeal.
So I hope it's repealed. Then we ain't got to worry about it.
I'm sure there's a wink and a nod somewhere in the process of when this legislation was passed. And look, I'll be frank with you, Moon. This legislation, I voted against it on the House floor. There was about 25 other brave members that went with me. But no one asked any questions because they were scared of the Senate president threatening their funding. And the minute the Senate president was no longer the Senate president, they all came to the Capitol lockstep saying how this was a bad idea. So apparently this legislation is put in place for the wrong reasons, and we're going to take it out for the right reasons. We're going to repeal it. That's my intent, and I hope that the rest of the legislature will support me.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. If we send it back, then I don't care. But I just think there was a Brundtland deal made, and this is why it is passed. This is not a good bill. I'm glad you and Con Peter are on it, and I'm glad to hear that law enforcement basically is with y'all saying that they need to get rid of this, because I think that will go a long way for the voters in the Senate and the House. I feel like getting out of the Senate committee was gigantic. So anything else you want to add real quick before I let you go?
No, I just wanted to mention that we have a bunch of great bills. I've got, obviously, you saw my constitutional carry bill. We discussed that on the show previously. I also have a bill that passed the Senate that bans sanctuary cities. I have another bill that passed the Senate which bans ranked choice leftist voting. We've got a number of other great pieces of legislation like reforming the welfare system and making sure that able-bodied adults between the age of 18 and 52 who have no children need to go back to work and be a contributing member of our society. The list goes on and on. I can tell you, Senator Seball and myself almost in a competition to make sure that we bring back all those bills that Governor John Bel Edwards vetoed, all of our great ideas,
yep,
plus things that'll move our state forward. And we're putting in overtime work at the Capitol for these first 6 months under Governor Landry, and his leadership has been tremendous. And we have a bright future ahead. And like I'll say, Louisiana's best days are ahead, and we will make sure that Louisiana people get the government that they deserve. They haven't been getting that the last 8 years.
Yeah. All right, man. Appreciate it, Blake. God bless. Best of luck.
Thank you so much. God bless Louisiana.
Senator Blake Miguez. All right, I take a break. Hopefully Tim will be in here in a minute. You're listening to the Moon Griffon Show. Line One is a business telecom provider. Line One specializes in cloud-based communication with superior customer service. If you're frustrated with phone bills you can't understand, endless hold time to customer support, and phone system that is not meeting your needs, then you need to go to Line.One and schedule a free consultation to advance your business phone system. Line One, technology with a human touch. Go to Line.One and tell them Moon sent you. Again, that is Line.One. Oh, Shucks, you've been hearing me brag about Shucks. Been going there for many, many years. Shucks does a great job. If you like seafood, you got to go to Shucks in Abbeville. I'm telling you right now, there's shrimp, there's oysters, there's fish, all fresh every day right off the boat. So if you want something fresh and you want fresh seafood, you got to go to Shucks. Don't forget, if you're having a party, call Shucks. Let them cater the event for you. Or you can go pick it up. Shucks, they're waiting on you. If you want a great time and you want great food, you got to go to Shucks in Abbeville. Shucks, oh, they're good. Folks, I want to tell you about one of my new advertisers, Adapt Concepts AC Service Repairs. Oh, serving all of Acadiana, surrounding areas, and the Gulf of Mexico for over 6 years. Full service AC and heating company. Repairs, installation, and preventive maintenance, which is very, very important. Installation service, professional quality services, focus on creating value for you. Terms of certified technician, 24/7 customer service, and free consultation. I'm talking Adapt Concepts, AC Service Repairs. You want the professionals, you want the best, this is them. Purchase a qualified, high-efficient system for maintenance plus get a free 12-year parts and labor warranty. Wow, don't you want to know about that? Call them at 337-408-8202. That's 337-408-8202. Or go to the website, adapt-ac.com. That's adapt-ac.com.
Looking for a place that...
Welcome back. Moon Graffon Show. It's an open forum edition. Talk about anything you want to. We can talk about food right now, at least somewhere.
Talking about or just eating it, huh?
Oh, man. Tim Metcalf joins us. Of course, Dino's Pizza and Prejean's. And, yeah, well, good to see you, man. Doing all right?
I see. I'm good, man. I'm good. I'm having a great day. So,
well, tell me about this fourth man, generation this pizza
stuff,
first.
This is stuff that makes me proud. So, my grandson, Riley James Metcalf, he works at South, and he will get more involved in the business, and he's Big Daddy, he called me Big Daddy. I got a pizza idea. So he walked him through how to make a pizza, create a pizza for the pizza of the month. And, man, he hit a home run. He's got it's our version of a chicken bacon ranch, but he put a Hispanic twist on it. So we have a margarita chicken marinade. Instead of marinating the chicken, he reduced the marinade and tossed the chicken in it. Then he put a Chipotle ranch that he came up with on top of it. And, man, it's good. But your son, Walker, just hadn't taken a breath yet. He's over there.
We went over there to eat the other day, and Walker came with me, and he said, man, that pizza of the month is what this is.
Pizza of the month.
Man, that looks good. I'm going to get it. So we got I don't know if we had a salad or pizza or whatever.
Pizza for one, yeah.
So I said, man, it does look good. He said, Dad, you ought to taste this. I said, well, give me a piece. He said, exact word. Give you a piece of my pizza. Tim's going to bring one Friday. That's your own son telling you that, bro.
Yeah, I know. Well, yeah. He didn't call me, but yeah. But you know.
Yeah, but you're saying you're proud because it's a grandbaby making.
Of course.
Pizza. Your daddy made it. You made it. Go for the
statistics on businesses to making the fourth generation. Not much of restaurants. All businesses. Moon, it's less than 4%. 4%. Now, all you good-looking girls that are listening out there, I don't know if you from Moon's show. My grandson's 21 this year. He's single, and there's no information on fifth generation.
By the way,
so I need a fifth generation. His mom's going to kill
me. Tim, no, who's going to kill you is that's how you got your wife.
Right? Right?
Making pizzas. I don't mean it like that, but she's working with a company.
No, absolutely. Better than a pizza restaurant. So.
And you're a typical man. Yeah. Ooh, look at this pretty lady.
Right.
Maybe
right.
I'll talk to her.
She didn't want to talk to me at first because she thought I was a fast boy. So.
But that usually makes the best marriages, the one that says, I don't know about that cat.
Right. That, right. Exactly.
So what else you got?
Oh, I brought the wings. So we took that sauce, that margarita chicken reduction, and we did the wings with it. But Putting the Chipotle ranch on the wings, it kind of didn't cover them, coat them properly. So he mixed the Chipotle ranch with the reduction sauce and came up with the Southwest sauce, which is we tossed the wings in it. And again, man, that's just, good.
It's something.
It is.
It's definitely something different.
Yeah.
And the flavor's real zesty.
Super unique. After you ate it,
it stays
right. There's cilantro on it. A lot of people don't like cilantro. Some people said it tastes like stink bugs. Whatever. We can hold that cilantro out. That's put on afterwards. That's not a problem. Well, no. Man, I'm telling you, it's good.
That's real good. All right, a lot of holidays right now because of Easter, people are off before, people are off after.
Right.
Affects restaurants up, down, all around, and you really don't know.
Joe was just sitting here a second ago saying how busy we were last night. It's just one of those things, like, it affects us. You can have a really slow, and then you can have a really busy shift. You just can't figure it out. You know, it's just going to come and go. You get a bunch of people that come, leave town. Your regular customers, they've gone to visit, or they're in Florida. They're not coming in on your Monday night, Thursday night. Everybody that came into town to visit their family, that's come back, that, you know, John Bell chased people out for 8 years.
Oh, yeah.
People are coming back from Texas.
Yeah,
people come back visit from Texas. They're like, man, remember Dino's, I'm coming in.
Let me ask you a quick question, because you got so much going on right now. You guys are trying to figure it all out. I noticed $20 minimum wage fee went in for in California. Tim,
that's ludicrous.
The average person, especially the nutted up left, understand that what you're charging right now, you'd have to probably double overnight.
It is.
Minimum.
It is. But think about this. They're very socialistic in the thing, so everybody's going to make $20. That's not how it works. I got cooks making $20 an hour. And they're good. They've been with me for years. And these cats, man, they hold to work. But my starting wage, somewhere 11, 12. Depends on what you bring to the table. It can be more. So let's just say $11 an hour. God, doesn't know anything. Wet behind the ears, but he can work the shifts.
He can work $11
an hour. $11 an hour. My guy's sitting there like, I'm making $9 an hour more than this guy. Hopefully he doesn't do the percentage. So when the minimum wage goes up, everything goes up, right? Burgers, everything goes up because everybody's paying more for labor. So my guy's not going to think, they're not going to be equal paying 20. You're not going to pay him 20 and he don't know anything. And I'm training him at 20. So I got to pay that guy 29, 36 if you go by percentages.
The person buying the product or service is going to pay it.
They're going to pay it.
And then they cut down. Walk in your restaurant when you got something like that.
So the guy on salary making $60,000 a year salary, he don't get a raise that much. So instead of coming to Dino's twice a week, he comes once a week, a month.
Could you imagine today, and people that go eat in your places, even here, and we didn't mention Praise Jones,
right.
If tomorrow, when they drove up, they sat down and went, well, hold up, this price is twice as much as it was yesterday.
Yeah, they get up and walk out.
So what? Yeah, you wouldn't have no business. That's what the left doesn't understand.
They don't understand business. They don't understand. They love to vote on spending other people's money.
Yeah.
But look, Hunter Biden ain't paid his taxes, but boy, daddy sure wants ours, doesn't he?
No doubt about it. All right, PraiseJones.com, Dino'sPizza.com. It's always good. Tim and them, very community-oriented. Love the state, and they do a great job, folks, catering. Big groups, you can handle
all. We do it all. Give us a call.
All right.
We got you.
That's it. Walker says that's it. Tim, thanks. Always. Food's great.
Thank you, man.
Tell your grandson he did one heck of a job.
I'll go
to South and see him. I don't go to South that much, but I'll go to
him. Yeah, go see, shake that young man's
hand. All right. Tim Metcalf. Thanks, Tim.
Louisiana is unique. The food, the festivals, even the bugs. It's termite season. Did you know termites are responsible for over $1 billion worth of damage in Louisiana alone? For over 60 years, J&J Exterminating has been shielding homes and businesses. 100% guaranteed against termites, pests, and mosquitoes. Louisiana owned, customer focused. J&J Exterminating.
Call them today, make the pests go away. J&J Exterminating.
Get the shield.
Yeah.
Spring is here, and if you love seafood like I do, you need Ragin' Cajun, the original Cajun seasoning, and Ragin' Cajun's delicious seafood dinners like etouffee, Creole sauce, shrimp and grits, seafood bisque, gumbo and roux. All Ragin' Cajun products are made right here in Acadiana. Folks, trust me, they are good. Ask for the Ragin' Cajun and all your favorite grocery stores today. Ragin' Cajun, the original Cajun seasoning. Ask them for the Ragin' Cajun. Oh, man, I love me some Superior Grill. Superior Grill, the best Mexican food in the state of Louisiana, bar none, baby. They are the best, and you're going to love them, too. They got great drinks and food, and the atmosphere is second to none. They know what they're doing. They know how to serve. Hey, folks, you do know they cater. They do cater. Superior Grill, located in New Orleans, Shreveport, and Baton Rouge, Lafayette right around the corner. You're going to love Superior Grill. You're going to love the atmosphere. You're going to love the taste. They can handle anything you got. Folks, they got happy hours. They really serve the people. And you're going to love Superior Grill. I love it. You're going to love it. I cannot wait to go to Superior Grill. I've been going to Superior Grill now for 29 years. Let me tell you, I know all about Superior Grill. And I want good Mexican food. I'm going to Superior Grill. I want to see you there. We're going to have a blast.
John Wayne Frazier.
This hour brought to you by Matthew James Tax and Wealth Management. Online at MatthewJames.com.
Hello, welcome back, Moon Griffon Show. Great to have you with us. Don't forget, we will give away some, Ragin' Cajun products. We'll do that at the end of this hour. You can email me, moon@moongriffon.com. moon@moongriffon.com. It's no problem at all. You got a chance to win. One guy trying to win, his name is Isaac Hayes. That ain't the Isaac Hayes. I'm about to say, if this is the Isaac Hayes, he'd come back to life. And number two, he'd have to sing for his victory. I said, Isaac Hayes out of Bro Bridge. You didn't win. Now, you might win, but you didn't win yet. This kind of throwing Isaac Hayes. I thought, wow, that brings back old memories. 844-766-6607. Matthew James, Tax and Wealth Management Hotline. By the way, I just want to tell you that prediction on the hurricanes came from not from the National Oceanic Atmospheric Administration, which is where they normally get it from. This is from University of Colorado. Season outlook from the National Oceanic Atmospheric Administration isn't due out to May. But those forecasts look at the same worrisome models and temperatures and seeing the same thing, nothing surprises us anymore. Yep. So last year, when many forecasts called a milder season, it was 20 named storms. Between 20 and 23. They see a raindrop on the radar coming out of over by Africa. There's two raindrops. This is a storm. Name it. You know? They have no idea. They have no idea. No idea. And they name it every storm now. By the way, I appreciate Senator Blake Miguez. Folks, they need to, no reason to have all that. They put the speed limit on 60 for every vehicle. Put those. And I'm glad to see that law enforcement in St. Martin Parish and Hillville Parish, where I'm from, I know he said Brett Stassi came. I've been friends. I knew Brett since we went to elementary school together, went to high school together before I transferred. So I ain't going to sit here and act like I know Brett because I ain't seen Brett but two or three times probably in 100 years. But Stassi was against it. They understand the revenue. They're going to double the fine, $700 for the average person who can't pay that. I do realize I've seen the wrecks. It took me 8 hours to get home from Baton Rouge one time. I've been in that stuff. People don't go too fast. I'm not even arguing with that. Give them a ticket. I got a ticket. I got one so far in the 10 years I've been living down here. Hillville Parish. I could have called Brett Stad and said, hey, Brett, can you take care of me? I don't know if I could have done that or not. I didn't. I paid my ticket. But I knew the sheriff who the sheriff was. Matter of fact, I was trying to be a little slick with it. I got to tell y'all, when the guy, the sheriff deputy, was writing the ticket, he came in and told me, said, yeah, I'm from Mill Parish. He said, okay. And he wrote the ticket anyway. I was born and raised in Blackman. I went to school with Brett Stassi. That's what I told him. And he went, okay, let me go write your ticket. I'll be back in a second. Never batted an eye. I just fell out laughing. I tried. I just didn't try any further. I paid my ticket. Go see it. It's all in the records. Go check. My bride asked me one time about a ticket. She said, well, you can get somebody you know. And I said, well, no, not us. Not the Griffon family. She said, what? I said, we're going to pay our ticket. I said, I ain't that. You got Sheriff so-and-so cut you a deal. I said, nope. I'm going to say my bride got mad at me. She didn't get mad at me. She said, well, you nuts. I don't care. We're paying our ticket. Your name, my name is on that ticket. We're paying it. And I paid my tickets. And I wish they did get fixed. I had family members going, and you know so-and-so and no, paying my ticket. You're going to pay yours. I'm going to pay mine. Even when I got red light camera tickets right here in Lafayette, and when they had the red light cameras here, Lord have mercy, I'd like to know how many tickets I got. I had to get, I've got six, eight. I know some people that didn't pay them. They told me, boy, you crazy. I would have paid one of them. And I get it. I said, nah, I'm on the air. First thing you know, old moon, on the air, and he getting a free deal. I get deals from being on the air, but that ticket ain't one of them. It's the way. But I'm so glad. Listen, the contract. It's always about the money, and that's what Blake Miguez, Senator Miguez, was saying. Somebody's going to get a lot of money and watch it. And that means this thing that Blank Page Cortez, and I told y'all about this guy, he pushed it because he had the power to push it, but he pushed it for somebody. Somebody was getting ready to make a fortune. I even hear he's working behind the scenes to try to beat it back now. And I hope we'll wake up and beat this back. I believe Landry is for getting rid of this too, which is good. Jeff's got a lot of power. I think it's real good if the governor would come out and say, look, I'm for getting rid of this. Nobody's trying to let speed merchants go by. So let the local governments make the money. Don't make it a speed trap. Just be out there in presence every day. You know the revenue's coming in. We'll pay for whoever's out there. There's always going to be danger on a bridge. Pulling people over is a danger on a bridge. Getting a ticket 2 weeks later, I just don't think that's right, and it's never been right. I think it constitutionally it's not right. But Blank Page knows that. He knows how to – if Blank had to put his hand on a Bible and knew God was looking at him, he could tell us right now who was going to get them contracts. Because everybody don't do this. Matter of fact, one of his buddies and one of the agencies right here, they're one of the only few companies that do that. We may never get to know who the company is. If the Senate would get – just by talking to Senator Miguez and other people about it, they felt like if they could get it out of the committee, they could get this passed. And then we'd get rid of the cameras, and we'd never have to know what company was getting ready to make a fortune. I'd rather just get rid of it and not know. But if we get stuck with these cameras, they've already wasted $500,000 buying the cameras. If we get stuck with these cameras, we're going to know who's going to get rich, and we're going to find out it's not going to be that hard, folks. We may have to trace a few things. Blank Page Cortez knows that. And I got to tell y'all, the bill, I forgot to ask Blake, this bill was passed 2 years ago, maybe more than 2 years ago. Why did it take so long? I mean, I know there's some bills that have to take. Why does this bill take so long? If this was about safety and we needed urgency, we needed to do something now, why did the bill take 2 years and they just now starting to put up stuff 2 years later? I think it was, 24 and 22, I think is when it was passed. Now, if I'm wrong, maybe it was last year, somebody can correct me. I'll be glad to say I'm sorry, but I think it was at least 2 years. And they waited, and of course, Blank Page ain't the Senate president. He's not in there. All of his buddies were in there to help him pass stuff like this. And a lot of them are gone now. So anyway, we'll see. I don't have that sitting in front of me. Let's see, you should tell an advocate to write a story about all administration bills that Edwards got passed so Blake and him can make sure that reverse the legislation. Oh, no, it's funny. Alan Seaball set it right up. Senator Alan Seaball said, we're going to undo everything Edwards did. That would be great for Louisiana because Edwards hurt us. People that don't realize that's because they're probably making money off the government. Bills like this got passed. Gambling got expanded because of Edwards and Blake Miguez, and I'm still trying to somebody come tell me how gambling produces. Gambling's great for society. But, boy, we expanded it under Blake Page Cortez because his buddy Joe Robidoux started lobbying for gambling. So they tight buddies. They live in the same driveway. One go right, one go left. Really, they both should have built their houses on the left side. Both Robidoux and Cortez should have built their houses on the left side. One was on the right, one was on the left, and I think that was – kind of funny, they should have built them both. Actually, same driveway. Opens up, doors open up, they go in, one goes right, one goes left. And that's why every gambling bill passed. That's why, like this bill right here, it passed because Blank Page put the pressure on it. That's just a fact, Jack. Yeah, 2022 law, that is. See, I remember that up here. Guy in the room's going, you remember that up here? That bothers me. It's a 2022 bill. I just remembered it off the top of my head. 2020, 2 years ago. Why'd it take so long? It's so important that we slow people down. Because he had to get out. We may never know who was going to get the contract. They only about one company, maybe two, that could do that contract. And it's represented by a company in Lafayette. I could go really into this deeply, but I won't. All right, when we get back, we'll pick a Raging Cajun winner. Of course, more to come. Don't go nowhere. You're listening to the Moon Griffon Show. Bring us in. If you love seafood like I do, you need Raging Cajun, the original Cajun seasoning, and Raging Cajun's delicious seafood dinners like etouffee, Creole sauce, shrimp and grits, seafood bisque, gumbo and roux, all Raging Cajun products are made right here in Acadiana. Folks, trust me, they are good. Ask for the Raging Cajun and all your favorite grocery stores today. Raging Cajun, the original Cajun season. Ask them for the Raging Cajun.
As Louisiana's only fiberglass manufacturer and fabricator, C-Safe Fiberglass Grating and Structural Systems has provided corrosion-resistant products to the Gulf Coast for over 45 years. Our fiberglass grating, cable trays, and structural shapes are ideal to replace corroded, rotting building products and can be custom fabricated by the best fiberglass craftsmen in the world, right here in Lafayette. Contact C-Safe or visit our website at csafe.com. That's S-E-A, like the ocean, S-A-F-E.com.
Louisiana is unique. The food, the festivals, even the bugs. It's termite season. Did you know termites are responsible for over $1 billion worth of damage in Louisiana alone? For over 60 years, J&J Exterminating has been shielding homes and businesses. 100% guaranteed against termites, pests, and mosquitoes. Louisiana owned, customer focused. J&J Exterminating.
Call him today, make the pests go away. J&J Exterminating.
Get the shield.
Yeah.
When you think about how... Hi, y'all. Welcome back. Moon Griffon Show. Great to have you with us. 844-766-6607 is the number if you'd like to be part of the program. Your opportunity to be a voice. Let me drink a little water. We've been eating too much in here. I've already had breakfast, lunch, and supper in the last 30 minutes in the studio. Ooh. If I burp, y'all forgive me. Anyway, yeah, that, you know, I had a friend of mine show me the 2022, and there it was on my paper. I was just in the back of my mind, knew it was a couple years ago, and I never understood why would it take 2 years to do something as simple as you. If you voted for something, you must have had the cameras in mind. But I know blank. I know a blank page. And Senate Transportation, Iowa, and Public Committee voted unanimously Wednesday to reverse the legislation. If it voted unanimously in this legislation, then it ought to be voted unanimously in the Senate to get rid of this. By the way, if the sheriffs and district attorneys of Iberville Parish, where I'm from, and St. Martin Parish doesn't want this, don't they should have a say? So, by the way, they only targeted one bridge. There's another bridge. What is it on? Is that 90 or 190? The one that goes through Crotch Springs and all that. What is that, 90? Okay. Okay, 090. 190. It's one. This is 90 right here. So 190, when you get a certain way over there, what is it, by the Morganza Spillway or whatever, that thing gets tight, man. And the speed limit is 55, whether you're a truck or car. They don't have a change in it. Why don't they, are they doubling the fines there? And if they are, I didn't see it on anything. This is pretty good. 2022, former Governor Bell signed an Act Number 426 in your law, was designated Chaffalai Basin Bridge a highway safety corridor, and proposed a three-phase process to implement safety instruction. I'm telling you why I think they did this. Two phases also changed speed limit to 60 mile an hour for cars and 55 for trucks. Anyway, and none of that even made any sense to me. Draft? Not a good move. Huh? Going to the draft?
He still has.
Okay, he can still change.
Bronny James will enter the 2024 NBA draft while maintaining his college eligibility. Well, yeah, also into the transfer
portal. It's changed a lot now.
Yeah. Okay. So you can go to a draft, but you can also just get looked at. And if you don't think you're getting drafted, you hit the portal and go back to college.
Well, he's hitting the portal for sure. All right, 844-7 this list. I know, folks, we did it on the air. Between son and father, okay, how about that? Arizona. Yeah, one of the things I wanted to mention. Oh, by the way, you see what Biden did yesterday? That's y'all president. It ain't mine. It's y'all president. Yesterday, Biden made it hard to fire government employees. Civil service. Administration installs new rules, making it harder to fire bureaucrats. The bureaucrats are running everything in Baton Rouge and Washington. Everything. And you got to be able to get rid of the bureaucracy. So Trump's coming on, and they worried Trump's going to win again, and Trump started going out to the bureaucracy. He talked about the swamp the first time. He found out the swamp is the bureaucracy. Biden just made it hard to fire people. This is what you do if you're in China. A new rule adopted by the Office of Personnel Management boosts protection of government employees, makes it harder to fire. Folks, people in the private sector get fired all the time. Ain't nothing hard about it. Biden administration issued a new rule making it harder to fire government employees in an apparent bid brought off former President Donald Trump's pledge to fire rogue bureaucrats and radically reshape the federal workforce. Folks, that's the most important thing we do in the federal government. See this EPA and Green New Deal? We get rid of it today. Cause it to go away today. They can start prices of vehicles going back down where they ought to be. The new rule bolsters job protection for career civil servants. In other words, I get a job here, they can't fire me. I can say and do whatever I want. They got companies that go down because employees were able to do whatever they say and want. Position on April 4th, which hinted a statement as targeting promise moved by potential second Trump presidency to drain the swamp and root out the deep state by making it easier to fire government workers. See, folks, this is the anti-Trump, but it becomes the anti-American movement by the Democrat Party left. He's the Democrat Party of filth and hate, and I'm being nice about that. Trump wants to get rid. That's where you got to go. That's where it's got to start. The heart and soul and the problem of this country is in the bureaucracy in Washington, D.C. If Trump's got to be able to, but no, Biden makes it hard now because some judge is going, well, you can't do that. This guy killed 4 people at work today. I don't care. He still got a job when he gets out. And it's all, if you read the articles, it's all about Trump hinting that I'm getting rid of this. Folks, why do people vote for Biden, Democrat? If you change it out to Michelle Obama, which I'm sticking to my guns on that, or you change it out to any Democrat, they all believe the same thing. There ain't nobody any different than Joe Biden. Some of them might have a little bit more brain power, but the brain waves go in the same way. And it's all, if you read the articles, it's all about Trump making a comment in a speech calling on Congress to pass laws that would give Commander-in-Chief the authority to fire any government employee basically at will. I like that. Congress should pass historic reforms empowering the president to ensure that any bureaucrat who is corrupt, incompetent, or unnecessary for the job can be told, you are fired, get out. So after such reform, Washington would be an entirely different place. That's our problem. Hey, by the way, before anybody jumps up and down, it's our problem in Baton Rouge, too. The bureaucracy, as a friend of mine, Jim Spillers, the late Jim Spillers, told me, he said, Moon, I like what you're doing, like you're doing the program. He said, but let me just tell you, when you cut through one bit of bureaucracy, you're going to hit another one right after it. And he was talking about in Baton Rouge, and I'd be dang, he was right. Every time we try to change something, it's so hard to do. Every time. By the way, the winner today for the Raging Cajun, what came up just popped up for me, Sandy Andropoint. I hope I'm saying it right. Out of Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Andropoint. I hope I'm saying it right. That's a different name. Sandy, I'm taking it as a girl lady. I probably shouldn't do that. You are the winner. I just pulled it. The computer got it for me. And I just sent it. So you're the winner. They get that stuff out pretty quick, too. So I look for you to have it soon. Anyway, Biden making it tougher on any president coming in because we, in other words, if the bureaucracy is hurting, choking the country, devastating this country, you can't fire them. Can you imagine that being in the real world? You got people making horrible decisions and business decisions. Your company's going down, money having problems and making one bad decision after another, and you can't fire them. Is that not cool? You can leave work that day saying, well, we lost another couple million dollars, but what the hell? They can't fire me. Can you imagine that in the real world? Well, that's what these civil service people have. Now, I know part of them, they're going to say, well, Moon, the reason they're doing that is, the reason they're doing that is, every time you got a new administration, somebody's going to get fired. You realize every time they got a company buys a company out, people get fired. People get let go. Happens in the real world every day. Why can't government be more like in the real world? Because it's been a failure. You run up $35 trillion worth of debt. You're a failure. You failed the country and everything else. That's not the way they look at it. So, once again, this is all pounding President Donald Trump. That's all this is. They hate him. They hate him with a passion, and they ain't going to quit. They don't care if we lose the country. They just don't want Donald Trump to be in charge. All right, we got to take a break. Jacob Isaac joins us. EVs, don't go nowhere. He'll be with us at 11:06, 11:07. All right, God bless. Have a great day.
For the absolute best in local Cajun food, check out Prejean's in their two locations in Carencrow and Broussard today.
This is Dave from the Dave Matthews Band for Rad. When you go out and party, get drunk, then drive, you're not only loaded, you're a loaded weapon. When you celebrate, designate. Choose a designated driver. Remember, music lives and so should you.
A public service message brought to you by the U.S. Department of Transportation, RAD, the National Association of Broadcasters, and the Ad Council.
To some, a baby's babbling doesn't mean much, but it does. Especially if there's no babbling at all. Little to no babbling by 12 months or later is just one of the possible signs of autism in children. Learn more at AutismSpeaks.org. Brought to you by Autism Speaks and the Ad Council.
For those fortunate enough to help the person who has always been their hero, find the care guides you need to help at AARP.org/caregiving. Brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
News Talk 96.5 KPEL, Brobridge, Lafayette, a Town Square Media station, broadcasting from the Matthew James Financial Studio.
This is a Fox News alert. A rare northeast earthquake. I'm Lisa Brady. It was centered in northern New Jersey near the city of Lebanon, about 45 miles west of New York City, but felt across the region from Philadelphia to Massachusetts. Preliminary magnitude 4.8.
It's part of the Ramapo fault system. It's the longest crack in the Earth's surface on the eastern side of the country. And when earthquakes do happen, as we know, it's very rare. But this is typically, it has typically been the spot that they have happened.
Fox meteorologist Adam Klotz.
And it was located just half a mile down, which is incredibly shallow as far as these things go, which is why so many people felt it.
What they felt varies. Reports of a slight rumbling to desks and computers shaking. James Pittenger, the mayor of Lebanon, New Jersey, again the epicenter, just telling Fox News there's no word of significant damage.
No reporting so far in Lebanon. I can say in my own garage, you know, going down there, things were knocked out, you know, off the walls, and you know, everything was all over the floor. So it was again something I've never experienced before.
There have been some wider transportation impacts as a precaution, including temporary ground stops at New York's JFK Airport and at Newark Airport in New Jersey. Bridge and tunnel inspections also underway. Getting reports the quake was felt in the clubhouse and on the field at Yankee Stadium, where gates are set to open soon for the home opener. A spokesperson says President Biden has been briefed and the White House is in touch with federal, state, and local officials. The quake also felt at the UN, where a Security Council meeting has been underway on the war in Gaza.
Nothing can justify
the collective punishment of the Palestinian people.
The head of the UN, Antonio Guterres, also says while the Israeli military acknowledged mistakes in the deadly strike on an aid convoy, Israel's policies, he says, allow for more mistakes. He's calling for an independent investigation. America is listening to Fox News.
Don't let everyday aches and pains keep you from living your best life.
I don't think I really understood what people meant when they talked about pain until I started feeling it myself.
Start feeling better every day with Relief Factor, a daily supplement designed to support your body's fight against aches and pains.
Not only do I move better without pain, I just feel better.
Created by doctors, Relief Factor uses a unique formula of natural ingredients that target four metabolic pathways to address pain. Relief Factor doesn't just mask aches and pains, it helps reduce or even eliminate them.
Today, I do the things I love, and it doesn't occur to me to think about pain.
You can feel the difference all day, every day.
Join the over 1 million people who have tried Relief Factor's 3-week quick start kit. It's only $19.95. Visit relieffactor.com or call 1-800-4-RELIEF. That's 1-800, the number 4-RELIEF. And feel the difference of Relief Factor.
A surprise in the latest jobs report.
The 303,000 new jobs last month were spread across many sectors, but healthcare, hospitality, and government saw the biggest gains.
It's just yet another expectations-defying job report.
White House Council of Economic Advisors Chair Jared Bernstein says the hot jobs market is not fanning inflation worries, he says, because wages are rising faster than prices.
Very important for families at the kitchen table to get some breathing room.
In a statement, President Biden says he's calling on large corporations to pass along record profits to consumers and eliminate so-called junk fees. At the White House, Jared Halpern, Fox News.
The president visits Baltimore today for a first-hand update on salvage updates after last week's deadly bridge collapse. He also plans to meet with family members of the six construction workers who were killed. Four bodies have not been recovered yet. A Wisconsin doctor who sued to protect abortion access and has performed abortions is running for Congress.
Democrat Kristen Lierley launching her candidacy for Wisconsin's 8th Congressional District. 2 weeks before Republican Rep. Mike Gallagher is set to leave the House seat for a position in the private sector. Lierley was one of the plaintiffs in a Wisconsin lawsuit that succeeded in keeping abortion legal after the U.S. Supreme Court overturned Roe v. Wade in 2022. For now, Lierley is unopposed in the conservative district, where two Republicans are running and a third is expected to get into the race next week. Jeff Manasso, Fox News.
Recapping our top story, the strongest earthquake to hit northern New Jersey in more than a century. And the 4.8 magnitude quake was felt by millions from Philadelphia to New England. No reports of any major damage or injuries. Wall Street rallying after yesterday's late plunge. Right now, the Dow's up 371. I'm Lisa Brady. This is Fox News.